it to the place that you asked today. I couldn't tell you to you straight, I gotta estimate. I wonder if I ought to go here with the best to say. Now go ahead, get me out of here, I couldn't last today. I got the city talking about me like I passed away. Automatic is a habit, you should know it's automated. I've been getting to it, I ain't noticed y'all was hating. Brand new chicks, you don't know the occupation. I just wanna know that I can hold a conversation. Oof, I don't know what y'all debating. I've been waiting for you, now I'm running out of patience. Running up a check, trying to run an operation. Went broke in the check and put a... Tell me about nothing. I'ma need something I can calm down from. I'm gon' pull up with the bar down one. 6 months saying I ain't got once. Tryna tell me what you know about me. You don't know nothing, keep it real with me. She said she ain't tryna deal with me. Okay, cool, you can sell that seat. Ooh, and she felt intrigued. She felt intrigued. Ooh, tryna duck the LMPD. Go and get your self-esteem. And she tryna link up. So much we got synced up. Pulled up in the dinged up whip. This ain't Pepto Biz with this pink stuff. Here's gonna tell me. Yeah, you heard me, you ain't felt me. I've been moving, I've been shaking, going, hit me on the celly. Try to sell me on something while I hold it compelling. Ever since I've been gone like Kelly, they been trying to tell me about this and that. I ain't chatting with you, we ain't going tit for tat. Trying to tell me how to get in the bag. We're going to get in the bag, I'm about to get in the. Automatic is a habit, you should know it's automated. I've been getting to it, I ain't noticed y'all was hating. Brand new chicks, you don't know the occupation. I just wanna know that I can hold a conversation. Oof, I don't know what y'all debating. I've been waiting for you, now I'm running out of patience. Running up a check, trying to run an operation. Went broke in the check and put $100 out of savings. And I can tell now that you ain't talking about nothing. I'ma need something I can calm down from. I'm gonna pull up with the bar down one. 6 months saying I ain't got once. Trying to tell me what you know about me. You don't know nothing, keep it real with me. She said she ain't trying to deal with me. Okay, cool, you can sell that C.
The city of Seattle, known for coffee, grunge music, and of course rain, and we're definitely going to get a heavy dose of the last of those three here tonight as you look inside a wet and wild CenturyLink Field. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the New England Patriots and the Seattle Seahawks. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1 yard gain up to the 26.
The tackle by Durham.
The last play got just a yard. Here's second and nine from the 26.
Second and nine at the 26 yard line.
Working out of the gun. Love. And incomplete on the deep ball. He was looking for Paul Richardson there. And that takes us from second to third down. And that throw behind his man, he missed him. Incomplete. This is third and nine. Love from the gun. Is this intercepted? It is. It's intercepted. Picked up by the linebacker, Jalen Smith. And they'll start with great field position at the 41-yard line. I'm not sure that you can say that the rain caused that interception, but look, it's clear that throwing the football is going to be tough in these conditions.
No doubt about it, and different quarterbacks handle it different ways. Some guys think the rain isn't a big deal, but wind affects them a little bit more. But you have to wonder, will these conditions hold scoring down? Are we going to have like a 9-6 type of a game? And then the pressure goes on the punters who often hold for field goal attempts. Can they handle the snap and get the ball down so they can kick it?
They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Brings up second and 11 at the 43-yard line.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Here's Eason to throw. They'll set up the screen to Elliott. He's got the first down here inside the 30. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down.
They ran that one well. And not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
They'll run on first down. Elliott, and he'll be tackled at the 23 after a gain of three.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a three-yard gain.
Second and six. No, scratch that. Second and seven. This is Elliott. A one-yard gain there following the three-yard pickup on first down.
He was taken down at the 22-yard line. A one-yard gain brings up third and six.
Couple of extra defensive backs in the ball game here on third and six. To throw on third down, Eason. End zone caught. Touchdown, Seattle. LaVisca Chenault with his first career NFL touchdown. And the Seahawks have taken a first quarter lead. They scored the most points of anyone on opening weekend, and now first quarter touchdown here.
And while there's no guarantee that all the points they scored in opening weekend are going to hold up and be the average all year long, they're certainly starting to set that type of a pace. And what you do with that is you put in the heads of all of your opponents. We've got to really be ready on defense because these guys know how to put the ball in the end zone.
You think they can keep piling on the points like this?
I think they can if they're prepared to adjust and adapt because they won't see the same defenses week in and week out.
The Pats at the line, ready to go. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 the score as they start first and 10. And they'll start the drive on the ground with Johnson. And he'll wind up with about six, up past the 30 to the 31. They'll come up now second and four from the 31.
Brings up
throwing. Love. That's going to be caught by Richardson.
Jordan Love.
So from the 36 now, first and 10.
Complete to Paul Richardson. A gain of five. First down, Patriots.
Out of the shotgun, it's Love. flush to his right. And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it. And it took the ball off course.
Different pass rushes are designed for different things. Sometimes you want to keep the quarterback in the pocket. Sometimes you want him to flush. I don't know exactly how this one was designed, but they made sure they moved him to his right. He got out of the pocket. Unfortunately for him, he was hit as he tried to throw the ball, and that resulted in an incompletion.
A second down throw for Love, and he slips up past the 45 before being tackled.
Complete to Chris Conley.
11 yards there, first down.
First down.
The first down carry here for Johnson. And he's up across midfield and down into Seattle territory. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
It's a gain of five.
Second down, Love. Complete. Richardson has it. And finally out of bounds inside the five at the four. It's a big play there for the Patriots. 45 yards. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the five. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. Back at the five-yard line now, second and goal. And he is in. Touchdown, New England. Kalen Ballage. His first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Patriots are within an extra point of tying this one up. On that sideline, they're saying that was more like it. The first down run went backwards, that time into the end zone.
And I like their little bit of courage in play calling, too. Because after an unsuccessful run, especially one where you lose yardage, you oftentimes go right to throwing the football. They came right back with a running play, and it paid off handsomely.
And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Seahawks take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you score points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Brings up second and eight at the 27-yard line.
The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. Eason going to throw it out of the shotgun. Escaping the pressure right. Able to hit his target, Claypool. And out across midfield, down to the 45. 27 yards there, a first down.
First and 10 at the 45-yard line.
So into Pats territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 45-yard line. These two teams all tied after one. Down to the 44.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it.
One of the great coaches said football is really a simple game. Rush theirs, protect yours. And he's talking about those guys throwing the football. In this situation, the rush won, hitting the quarterback and forcing him into an incompletion.
On third down, Eason. they will take over possession of the football at their 42-yard line. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape, he's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on-the-job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
And he'll lay out and pull it in. What a diving catch there. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
Maximum effort, partner. Minimal gain.
Yeah, minimal gain. Looked good, though. That first down completion only netted him 3. Second and 7. Now a handoff. Johnson pushing forward for 3 up to the 48.
Carry on Johnson, the ball carrier. The tackle by Derwin James. A 3-yard gain on the play.
On third down, Johnson. And he gets it down to the 48. Enough for the first.
In the ball carrier.
On third down, that's a good job of situational football and understanding where the first down marker was and getting there.
And the Patriot first down.
First down, going to the air with Love. And he was hit as he threw it there, and it forces it incomplete. Defensively, Charles, they continue to really limit this offense as far as yardage goes.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been assignment sound, staying in their lanes, keeping proper leverage, and communicating well, too.
Here's second and 10. To throw again, Love. He finds Kalen Ballage, his running back. And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone. 28 yards the gain there on the catch and run.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
They run it with Ballage. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. This gain not quite as good as the last, but still over 40 yards between the two.
At the 5-yard line.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And not a whole lot there. He does get a couple, taking it from the 5 down to the 3.
And a nice job defensively to keep him out of the end zone. He's trying to get a second touchdown already in the first half.
They had that one earlier, was bidding for a second. So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal. Here's a run with Ballage. That he's over the line and into the end zone for a Patriots score.
New England.
Kalen Ballage with 2 touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the Patriots have taken the lead.
His kick is good.
And his kick is good.
Patriots 14. Seahawks.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And they will watch this one land in the end zone. That'll be a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. That 7-0 lead of theirs short-lived as they've now given up 2 straight touchdowns to fall behind by 7.
Yeah, but no cause for discouragement here. Yeah, they've fallen behind, but haven't they proven that they can go down and score? So what was the formula that got them down there the first time? Get back to something close to that, and maybe they get this game tied up.
At the 24-yard line.
Ball at the 24 and a 2nd and 11. Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. Eason on second down, and that is incomplete.
That's a nice job there because you've got to play the ball, not the man when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties. He's able to knock that one away.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. From the gun is Eason. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Marlon Humphrey, and he'll bring this one back to the 29. Second interception for him now here in this first half. And you got to think he's a rookie, Charles. How much does confidence start to become a factor?
I think that's a great question because that's what they're going to check on when he gets to the sidelines. The coach is going to check on, his teammates going to check on it, because when you haven't done it before, it's not something that's part of you. You got to see how you're going to react. Let's see how he bounces back.
Yeah, there's two interceptions for him in college and a half. I mean, that just didn't happen. No gain on the play there. Second down. Defense able to get there. Swarm to the football. Zilch. Zero nada there for the offense, Charles.
Yeah, it really was an example of good team defense, wasn't it? Everyone handled their responsibilities, and they held them to no gain.
They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves them with third and nine looming. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. The gun, Love, and able to find Conley, and he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. New England, Chris Conley, 28 yards, and the Patriots add 6 to their lead. It's good, and it is now 21-7.
Makes the score Patriots 21.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. That's fielded on the back line of the end zone. And he's probably realizing he should have stayed in the end zone as he can only muster a return to the 14-yard line.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive. Almost what we call the green light, red light theory. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Good positioning, and it's picked off. And his guys will set up shop at midfield at the 50-yard line.
The 50-yard line.
They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10, right at the 50-yard line. Following the interception, Love. Man open, that's Robert Foster complete. And he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. Robert Foster, 50 yards. And the Patriots add on to their lead.
They have really had their way so far in the first half, but they wanted to continue to build on their lead. They know that no lead is safe in this league, so they decided to try their best to get one more as they headed into the half, and they got it done.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And this one will not be handled. It's into the end zone for a touchback.
Their own 25-yard line.
Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. Well, look at the clock here. You're inside of a minute. First half hasn't gone that well for you. How are you going to play this drive?
Well, I've been told by my coaches previously that the intelligent approach, go ahead and run out the clock and start over. Don't make any more mistakes. But there's also something to understanding that you got this last drive here. You get the ball to start the second half. Try and go 2-for-1 here. Get some points now and come out of the locker room and get more points again and get your momentum really built up.
And that's Elliott complete. And they're able to get this one across the 35.
And
Now the Seahawks call the second of their three timeouts as the clock will stop with 45 seconds to go in the first half. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Operating from the gun, Eason, and he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Now the Seahawks forced to use their third and final timeout as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. 6-yard line. First and 10, Eason. He'll take a shot for the end zone. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone for the Seahawks touchdown. LaVisca Chenault with two touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the Seahawks are able to close the gap just a bit. It's up and good, and it's now 28-14.
Makes the score Patriots 28, Seahawks 14.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive, almost what we call the green light, red light theory. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. They'll indeed start on the ground to run that clock. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number one. Options galore here, second and a few inches. From the gun, Love. A 50-50 ball here, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the rookie, A.J. Terrell. They've got a pretty comfortable lead right now, but maybe a little too careless with the football that time for the rookie.
I think the key word there is comfortable, and there's two schools of thought on it. With that type of a lead, maybe you can take a few more chances because you have a cushion. Others will tell you, don't eat up the cushion with careless play. He'll learn to ride that line as he moves on in his career. If you know, you know. 19 Tiger, 19
Tiger. They'll throw on first down with Eason. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Chidobe Awuzie with a pick. And a potential turning point as they'll get the football in very good field position late in this first half.
They'll take over first and 10 at the 41-yard line.
Shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Throw left side complete. It's Richardson. And he's going to be out of bounds down around the 35-yard line. A gain of six there on first.
A 6-yard
from the 35, back to work on second and four. From the gun, a run for Johnson. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. And quite a bit of pizza in this box. It's a 53-yard attempt. And he's gonna miss this one. Wide to the left from distance. It's no good. So at halftime, it's the Patriots with the advantage. As we'll send you eastward to Orlando, standing by with that EA Sports Halftime Report now is Jonathan Coachman. Take it away, Coach. Forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. And the third quarter will start with a touchback as that one lands in the end zone. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. Here's second and seven now from the 28. Play action. It's Eason. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. That's Shaq Barrett, last year's sack leader, gets in there to register another one.
Now, we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight-ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. Looking deep downfield. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's fourth down.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started, and that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty. And before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
And this punt goes out of bounds, and it'll be marked inside the 40.
At their own 38-yard line.
The Pats at the line, ready to go. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
How about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion. Again, it's Balazs, and he's going to be stopped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39.
Made by Jalen Smith.
We know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
Every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. On third down, Love. Open man here is Foster. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. It'll be a Patriot first down on a pickup of 16.
New England.
They'll run on first down. It's Johnson. Jalen Smith tied for sixth in the NFL in tackles last year, in on the stop there. After the pickup of five, here's second and five.
Brings up second and five at the 41-yard line.
Operating from the gun, Love. He finds his man, Johnson. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. That one good for 20 on the catch and run.
And the Patriots first down.
First down, Love to pass. That he's going to go down. Back at the 27-yard line, he's sacked. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
Now a second down throw for Love here. This one into the hands of the running back, Belange. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. It'll be a pickup of 15 as that'll lead to third down.
That's a good bounce back play right there after taking a sack on first down. Didn't quite get it to the marker, but now they're in a much better spot for a third and short yardage call. Through the offensive coordinator, you like looking at that section a heck of a lot better than trying to figure out third and long.
Now a 10th carry for Johnson. And he's got the first down as he gets it to the 8. Give him a gain of 4, able to convert, and that sets up first and goal now. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and wide.
And he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. An 8-yard touchdown run. And the Patriots, they add on to their lead. Always important to get the first score of the second half. Now you start to pull away a little bit and get some breathing room going.
And now we find out about the fortitude of a group that's behind, because they were counting on getting into the game a little bit more, right? Maybe they get the first score. That doesn't happen. It looks almost insurmountable, but it's not. Let's see how hard they play the rest of the game.
And this will not be fielded. It's a touchback and comes out to the 25. Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Second down at 7. From the gun, Eason. He goes full extension, and he's got it. Rookie to rookie on the hook up there, and it's a first down.
Seahawks. First and 10 at the 48.
On first down, Jacob Eason. Eluding the pressure right. And my goodness, another interception. Picked by Kevin Byard. And a great return as he gets this all the way down close to the 30-yard line. A young quarterback, Charles, rolling to his right. I know he's right-handed, but is that one that maybe a veteran sticks in his pocket?
I think so, but you have to remember with young quarterbacks, it may take a few years before they get all the stuff out of them that they did earlier in their career or even in their college days when they were used to being dominant. In this case, the NFL veteran defense ended up winning the battle.
A good run, got 7 on first. Here's 2nd and 3.
On the Seahawks, 24-yard line.
They'll stay on the ground. Belange again. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down.
First down, Patriots.
Love, they go play action now. Stocker's got it, complete. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. That one goes for 16 yards. It sets him up first and goal. This is something you got to be wary of defensively. I mean, just because they're in the mode of trying to burn some clock doesn't mean they won't pass it. They got good yardage out of that one.
Yeah, and really, when you're looking at it, now they've got a fresh set of downs.
And he is in. Touchdown, New England. A 5-yard touchdown run. And the Patriots add 6 to their lead. And that rushing touchdown is fourth, puts him just one shy of the NFL record in a single game.
And we all know he would love to get to that record and even beyond it, but he doesn't need to in order to impress in this one, does he? What a performance. What an absolute great game that he's had here in this one.
And he'll be brought down right on the chalk of the 20.
Over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. Finding Knox there, complete. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game, throwing the football. So what you got to do, you got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end, take some easier completions.
The interception last drive, there he hits the reliable target. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. 7 yards the pickup. First down, Seattle. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. And now here is another interception. Picked by Kevin Byard. And he'll take it across midfield to the 46-yard line. Boy, so another interception, CD. It feels like he's starting to unravel a little bit.
And as you would expect, still a work in progress here in his second season. He has to start ironing out some of these mistakes, though, because now his head coach, his offensive coaches, they have to evaluate whether you keep playing him and let him work through it, or you start thinking about going to his backup.
That one good for 13 at a New England first down. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10.
Mike 56. Two little cupcakes. Switch.
Balazs.
That's it, baby. There it is. That's what I'm talking about, baby.
So the Patriots with a football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over.
Mike's by four.
Let's set a tone, fellas. Let's set a tone.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
Tight end right. Four down. Alert.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. That gain of 15 gets him on the doorstep, first and goal.
At the 3-yard.
Well, that last run makes this a 100-yard night. I've loved the way he's hit the holes. He's been quick, he's been decisive, and he's been a whole lot of fun to watch.
Love
kept it in his hands and tried to push it across the goal.